people are able to forgive. And I've seen people overcome prejudice, ageism, gender bias, classism, and so forth. There's so many applications. Again, politics, physical appearance, education, nationality. How about this one, even religion? I commented earlier that the Assyrians knew very little theology. At least, I think that's a fair deduction. If their primary education in the way of the Lord was Jonah's message, all they heard was, well, God is serious about sin and you better repent. Destruction's on the way. So it seems that they lack a complete understanding of the true God. Now, that's different from completely lacking any understanding of God, but they lack complete understanding of God. Can we be that way? Can we be like Jonah? I think so. We'll say, well, that guy, he's in the wrong denomination. Well, she doesn't understand fully Doctrine X. She doesn't really understand everything about Doctrine Y. That group, they don't do it the way we do it. They have a different style, a different approach. They have different traditions. And we can become insular even in our faith, even in our church family, acting as though we're the only ones with a stake on the truth, a claim to God's word. I really do hope that if you haven't heard it, you'll listen to the seminar we held in 2009 on prejudice and separation. And it wasn't just on racism and the black-white problems of the U.S. It was on political division. It was on historical prejudice in the church. And really, all over the world, there are multiple prejudices in each locale, in each nation. All kinds. I do hope you'll listen to that seminar. It could be eye-opening. Well, what do we learn about God? If we don't learn something about God, then theologically, the podcast has not really helped us. Three things I would like to emphasize, three things I learn about God as I study Jonah. And every time I read it, that nail gets driven deeper and deeper into that plank. Number one, the people of God tend to be insular, whereas God is open, expansive. And I'm not denying that there are a judgment day and a black and white and a right and wrong. That's not the point. But the people of God have a tendency to be exclusive, while the Lord surprises us by being so inclusive. Jesus' inclusivity was a scandal in his own day, the way he reached out to those that decent people would avoid, the tax collectors, the prostitutes. It's really no different today. To put it a different way, God is love. He's not partial. With him, there's no prejudice or favoritism. But we don't always get it. We don't always understand that God is expansive and inclusive. So, second, God sometimes goes to extremes to get our attention. Just look at the way God interacts with Jonah in this short book. Because we don't understand, point one, that God is not prejudiced. Sometimes God has to go to great extremes, point two, to get our attention. And then we have the good news. Although for Jonah it wasn't good news, for you and me, it should be. Point three, when man repents, God relents. When people turn to the Lord in faith, they find a God with a large heart, open arms, and a willingness to forgive. God is expansive and inclusive. God will sometimes go to extremes to get our attention. Certainly has done that to get my attention. And when man repents, God relents.